Bob, you're a little bit of a China expert. And actually, when we're talking the break, you take issue by the fact that the U.S. administration is now saying something that the Chinese currency did, which is actually intervened to weaken it, which it clearly hasn't in your eyes.
Yes. I've been going to China since 1972. The currency has always been a big issue, or not always, but recently at least, a big issue in terms of the American rhetoric about China. But let me make two points. One, it is overblown in terms of what we should be focusing on. But two, if we're going to focus on it, we got to get it right. And the fact is the Chinese are not pushing the value of their currency down. They've been allowing it to rise for two reasons, not just to placate the United States, which is what the press writes about, well, the U.S. will feel better about it. The Chinese want capital to continue to flow in. If their currency is depreciating, it's a disincentive for people to invest in China. They want to keep the growth rate up. They want foreign investment of a certain type to come in. The second big issue is not so much the currency rates, although they're not unimportant, but they're not the dominant issue. The dominant issue is the restructuring of the Chinese economy. We were talking about this during the break, and I think we both agree the real question for China and for us is, are they going to restructure? Are they going to continue the opening process? Are they going to work with the United States on these technology, intellectual property kinds of issues? The Chinese clearly want, they have this policy, China 2025, to strengthen biotech, strengthen autonomous vehicles, strengthen IA, all these kinds of things. But so they want their companies to play a more dominant role, but they still want foreign investment to come in. Americans understand they're not going to come in if they're worried about piracy of intellectual property. So that's really the technology area, not the tariff area, not the exchange rate, but the question of how you work together on new technologies to encourage American companies to come in, China part, and for American companies to feel they can come in comfortably and not worry about their intellectual property.
Right, and if it was only on IPs, actually, they'd also have the support of the Europeans.
Yes, you see, that's where the alliances come in. You can get other countries.
And to having support you.
And that's why pulling back from TPP was a bad idea, because that had strengthening elements for intellectual property and for other things that would give other countries a sense that they're working with the United States on this issue, not against China, but globally.